Hi everyone, I'm Chris Frame and thanks so much for joining me. In normal times, cruise ships have hundreds, if not thousands, of crew on board. This is in addition to all the passengers, sometimes numbering in the thousands. In fact, on the largest cruise ship, there are over 5,000 passengers on board, in addition to all of the officers and crew who are there to run the ship. But during the COVID-19 cruise shutdown, things are a bit different. For almost a year, the majority of cruise ships have been laid up, anchored and seemingly silent, awaiting a return of passengers. But if you've been paying attention to these ships, you might have noticed that they are still operational. The empty cruise ships move around, running on their own engines, with some of them even coming into port for a day or two every so often. So they're not really empty. I mean, someone has to be on board to keep the ships running, right? And if you're anything like me, you're probably wondering, what exactly is going on board the cruise ships? Who's on board and what are they doing? The officers and crew manage all aspects of the cruise experience. From things like navigation, safety and engineering, to hotel experiences, the entertainment, food and beverage. Obviously at the moment there aren't any passengers on the majority of the world's cruise ships, so the roles on board aren't exactly what you would expect during normal times. Legally, all ships must carry a master or a captain, as well as a chief engineer, even when in warm layup. Additionally, all the cruise ships need to hold a minimum manning certificate, which specifies the number of crew each ship can carry. The country where the ship is flagged dictates the minimum number of crew that a ship must carry. However, the laid-up cruise ships are actually carrying above that minimum requirement. This is stipulated by the cruise lines. As a general rule of thumb, there is around 100 to 120 people on each of the laid-up cruise ships. For most cruise ships, this will be made up of around 30 officers, with the rest being crew to undertake various roles. Additionally, in some jurisdictions, a ship carrying more than 100 people will require a qualified medical practitioner, even during the layup period. So now we know that there are people on board the laid up cruise ships, even when they're stationary and anchored off the coast. But you might be wondering how long each of the individual crew members is on board the ship for. In the early stages of the cruise pause, some crew stayed on board the ships for many months. In fact, at one point, the number of stranded crew numbered over 100,000 people. The causes of this problem were logistical, political, and geographical. In early 2020, no one knew how bad COVID was going to get. In January and February, most of us just went about our normal everyday lives. Trains kept running, aircraft kept flying, and cruise ships sailed to all corners of the world full of passengers and crew. As a result, cruise ships were scattered all over the world at the time the cruise shutdown started in March. Passengers were disembarked, but most of the crew remained on board the cruise ship as the cruise pause was only scheduled to last a month or so. At the same time that the cruise pause started, many countries around the world started to close their international borders. This meant that when the cruise pause was extended, the ships couldn't simply pull into port and disembark their crew or book them a flight home and get them home easily. Instead, repatriation was a logistical nightmare, requiring negotiations with various ports and governments and creative thinking on how to get the crew members back to their home countries. I've linked to my video about crew repatriation in the description below or in the info card here, but in short, it took months to rectify. Things became a little bit easier in August 2020 when the United Nations International Maritime Organization declared seafarers as essential workers. This removed blockages in many areas and greatly assisted the cruise lines in repatriating their stranded crew. A new normal has now been established, with crew changes taking place regularly. Anyone joining the ship has to undergo rigorous COVID testing and daily symptom checks, as well as periods of quarantine and isolation. Only after this, if they remain virus-free, are new arrivals allowed to leave their quarantine and mingle with the rest of those on board. Additionally, most cruise lines now require crew to wear masks at all times, unless they're in the privacy of their own cabin. While things seem worse during the COVID era, one area that has improved for the crew is their accommodation on board the ships. In fact, the crew have largely been moved into passenger accommodation, with balconies being the preference. This allows the crew to have more space per person and also utilize the balcony to ensure fresh air comes into the cabin. This is a far more spacious environment than the standard crew cabins that most of the crew will be used to. On many ships, crew are being fed in the main passenger buffet restaurant, which have been altered to create hygienic, COVID-safe environments. Some other passenger areas of the ship are also utilized. For example, a specific passenger lounge or bar may be used for crew functions, and a good example of this is recent Christmas celebrations, which were held on board many of the cruise ships in the passenger areas. So there's a small crew on board the cruise ships, and we now know how they're being accommodated. But you might be wondering what the crew is doing on board the ship during the cruising pause. Firstly, there's a team who run the ship. This includes the captain, chief engineer, and officers responsible for navigation, propulsion, power generation, maintenance, safety, and manning a 24-hour watch. Throughout the cruise pause, the cruise ships have remained in class, which means that they are still registered as cruise ships and have to meet all of the statutory requirements. This includes weekly emergency drills, lifeboat lowering, launch tests, as well as weekly cabin inspections and hygiene inspections. Maintenance teams are on board to ensure the upkeep of the ship during the shutdown. These teams maintain the decks, remove and treat exterior rust, paint the ship, and assist with engine room maintenance and maintain the balconies. They also undertake some tasks you may not have thought of. For example, to ensure public health and safety standards are met, all the empty cabins on board have their taps and faucets opened and toilets flushed regularly. This is a big job, particularly on those cruise ships with thousands of cabins. Now, you might be wondering about the cuisine on board. Well, rest assured, there is a team of chefs on board the ship to ensure that the crew are fed properly. There's also a small team of stewards on board who provide the crew with meal service and ensure the dining areas are kept stocked and clean. Additionally, a small hotel team can be found on board the cruise ship. Aside from cabin servicing, they are mainly concerned with deep cleaning. This includes all the furniture and upholstery, carpets and tiles, as well as behind the scenes area that require cleaning and upkeep. Now, just because there's people on board the cruise ships doesn't mean that the experience on board is anything like what you're used to. In fact, far from it. Most cruise ships are huge for the number of crew that they're currently carrying, and as such, many public spaces are mothballed until cruising resumes. These areas are protected by plastic coverings to ensure that they remain dirt and dust free. But while they're mothballed, these areas are still accessible, with all the various corridors and passageways needing to remain open to allow for proper ventilation and airflow. Regular inspections take place on board the ship. There are security teams on board with 24-hour patrols of exterior areas, as well as fire patrols inside the ship. While the cruise shutdown has been characterized by anchored, laid-up, idle cruise ships, the cruise ships themselves actually do move around quite often. This has been facilitated by cruise companies coming together to share the limited anchorages around the world. When a cruise ship sets sail, it can be to move to a new anchorage location or to exchange water. They also go to sea when prevailing weather makes anchoring unsafe or in response to a change of wind or sea conditions. All cruise lines expect to resume cruising sometime in 2021, and so at the moment, behind the scenes, the cruise lines are working very hard to prepare the ships for a return to service. This includes the monumental task of recrewing their ships. This will take months and can be as challenging as the crew repatriation effort was, but we will start to see crew returning to the cruise ships in the coming months. This is certainly a very strange experience for all involved. Never before has the world's fleet of passenger ships been laid up for such a long period of time en masse like this. But the cruise ships aren't empty. So the next time you see a laid up cruise ship off the coast, spare a thought for the crew on board who are keeping it safe and maintained and ready for cruising to resume in hopefully the not too distant future. Thanks so much for watching, and I hope you found the video interesting. If you did, please don't forget to give it a like and subscribe and hit the notification bell so you don't miss future videos. If you're interested in what else has been going on during the COVID-19 shutdown, check out my COVID and cruising playlist. If you're looking for something to do during lockdown and you're missing cruising, you might want to check out some of our books. We've written a series of books about ocean liners and passenger ships, and I've linked them in the description below. Today I wanted to show you the Cunard Colouring In book. It's full of colouring in pictures of the various Cunard ships. There's all sorts of interior pictures that have been turned into colouring in images, from the Winter Garden on board Queen Victoria, through to QE2 in Sydney Harbour, and of course, the great Cunard Queens docked around the world. And we also have a section on the history of Cunard as well. Thanks so much for watching, and when it is safe for us to travel again, I hope to see you on board.